Hi, this is Professor Sandeep Kambri here, and welcome you all to our next lecture in the course Intellectual Property Rights. So currently we are discussing about treaties for the protection of IPR, in which three treaties are there. First one, which we discussed in our last lecture, that is Madrid Protocol. Today we are going to discuss about second one, that is Bern Convention. So basically, as we know, all these three treaties are having and particular aim to protect intellectual property rights throughout the world. In the first treaty, that is Madrid Protocol, we have gone through, that is all type of the marks, basically trademarks, which can be protected through that specific treaty. Here in Bern Convention, okay, Bernese Convention or Bern Convention, okay. Again, one form of intellectual property can be protected, and that is copyright. Okay, and basically, as we know, all these treaties are administered by or governed by this World Intellectual Property Organization, which is a apex body in governing all these three treaties. Other than treaties, some other functions are also carried out by the World Intellectual Property Organization, which we have already discussed in our previous lectures. So Bern Convention, which is protecting copyright or the rights of author. Okay, copyright in the last lecture or in our previous lectures, we have gone through this copyright. At that time, actually, I forgot to insert this type of images, so that about copyright we are able to understand properly. So this is an image of the book. Name is Molecular Genetics. Objective type of book is there. This is cover page of the book, and inside the book, this is back side of the first page of particular book. So here book is written by the author, that is Kundan Singh, and the publisher of the book is Kalyani Publishers. In this first or the back side of the first page, in all type of the books, not only this molecular genetics, any subject, any type of the book which got published by any author, by any publisher, we are able to check that this capital sub in the circle, capital C is there, and then date is there, that is 2012, author KPPH 9973050. Okay, that is Kalyani Printings and Publishing and Publishing House, okay, something like that. Not important this long form or these numbers, but the important thing is that this particular book is protected under the copyright law. And firstly, it was published in 2012, so this mark is there, and this particular data is there, which is showing that, which is itself and mark of protection of this particular book under the Copyright Act. Okay, so nobody else is able to copy the data from the book and publish again in his book. Okay, if somebody is doing the same, that will be against the law and some action will be taken by the author, original author. Okay, so this is how on the back side of the front page or first page of the book we are able to check this data. You may check any book which is having with you. So this is one of the example by the author, that is books. Another example is there, that may be poet written by the author. Then some story writers are also there. In case of cinematograph, movies, again authors are there, mainly behind the story in the movie. Always there is an author. Okay, whenever stories are there, whenever books are there, whenever novels are there, whenever dramas are there, all these things need to write by somebody, and that is our author. So all these type of work, even music are there, some music files are also there which are composed by again musician. Okay, so that is also one of the type of author. Okay, so that type of the work also can be protected under the copyright. So this we already have discussed about. Today we are discussing in the Berne Convention how we are protecting this literacy and artistic work. Okay, and literacy, that is nothing but our books or anything which have wrote by any particular person, that is author. And artistic work, that is nothing but the dramas, cinematographs, movies, all these things can comes under this artistic work. Moving on to the next slide. So Berne's Convention, it was, so first of all, in the last lecture itself we have discussed that this Berne Convention, that is Berne, which is the capital of Switzerland, and this particular protocol was signed in that particular location, city. That's why the name is given, that is Berne's Convention. Okay, and which was signed on 9th of September 1886. First of all, location Bern, Switzerland. Okay, now parties, again the word is there, and I already told you people, here parties are the members of this Berne's Convention. Okay, like in WTO, WIPO, number of parties are there. Here also in the Berne's Convention, currently members are there, that is 179 members. It's nothing but the 179 countries are the members of Berne Convention. Okay, which are following this different protocols given in the particular protocol. Here in this convention, total 38 articles are there. Each of one is having particular directions which are related to the protection of literacy and artistic works. Next important point, that is depository. Now what is this depository? Okay, so whenever such type of treaties are there which are working international level or national level, at that time we have to keep that particular material with the depository. Okay, always these depositories are there. And here also, Director General of World Intellectual Property Organization, that is WIPO, is the depository for the protection of copyright. Means what? whichever type of the work you are looking for protection, that all type of the work you need to keep a copy of the work in this particular depository along with the filling of forms and all those formalities. You need to keep a copy of your work. It may be you are a musician, it may be your music file, it may be a drama, it may be any book. All those you need to keep in this depository. Next important point, that is languages. When it was signed, number of languages are there, that is French, English, Arabic, German, Italian, Portuguese and Spanish. Next point, it is most significant international convention in the field of protecting copyright. Okay, one of the important point, because in the copyright we have discussed that whenever we are protecting our work, it will get protected in our country itself. If somebody else taking this book, translating in his own language and publishing in some other countries, then you are not able to say it may be copied, something like that. Okay, because your book is not internationally protected. It is not protected beyond our boundaries of our country. So copyright IBAN convention is mainly important for the protection of our copyright throughout the world. Throughout the world means what? For these 179 countries which are currently members of the convention. Beyond that, or other than this 179 countries, if anybody else from other country taking this book, then it is not applicable for those countries, because they are not the members of this Bernese convention, and as they are not the members, there will not be need to follow the Bernese convention directions. So that it is also important that that country should also have the member of Bernese convention. Next point, India has been member of convention since January 10, 1975. Okay, when the India got signed and become a member of this Bernese convention. Then next important point is that is some basic principles are there of the Bernese convention, in which first is there, that is national treatment. Okay, national treatment is nothing but all these 179 countries, whichever it may be, if anybody, any author from this country, and he is willing to protect his work under Bernese convention, then that particular application will be applicable to all remaining 178 countries. Okay, no need to go and separately fill the forms or complete the formalities to get protection. Just need to fill a single form, go for the only once completion of formalities, and your work will get protected in the remaining 178 countries. That is the principle of national treatment. Okay, you just need to publish in one of your home country. And one important point is that your home country or the origin country should be the member of this Bernese convention. Then only you will able to protect your work, otherwise no. Second important point is there, that is automatic protection. In the world itself, we are able to understand what is this automatic protection. Once you got completed the formalities and filling the application form, your work will get automatically protected throughout the 179 countries. And one more important point is, protection must not be conditional upon compilers with any formality. Okay, just need to fill only once. Then third principle is there, that is principle of independence of protection. Now here protection is independent of the existence of protection in the country of origin of the work. Means what? For example, as per the Bern Convention, we are protecting the work for 50 years, just for our understanding purpose. And any home country is there, or origin country is there, that country is providing the protection for more than 50 years. That is also okay. Even though if the country is denying beyond certain limit, that is also okay. Okay, so principle of independence of protection is, as per the Bern Convention, there is a definite time period is defined for the protection, but even after that, you are able to protect as per the origin country, that is independence of protection. The contracting state provides for a longer term of protection than the minimum prescribed by the convention. Okay, this is important point. And this is your independence of protection. Moving on to the next slide. Work protected under Bernese Convention. Which type of the work? Okay, and as we discussed, literacy, scientific, artistic domain. Okay, all type of your cinematographs, music files, any new music, songs, any new authored dramas are there, which can be protected under the Bernese Convention. Then next important point, that is rights protected under Bernese Convention, right to translate, right to broadcast. Okay, if any movie, for example, just to take an example of movie, if any movie is there which was originally produced in Hindi, and later on producers want to translate it into Tamil, Telugu or English, they are able to do it independently. Then right to broadcast. Whenever they are preparing any music, any book, any dramas, broadcasting of that particular or publishing of that particular is their own right. Second one, adaptation and arrangement of the work. Sometime what happens, any author is there who is a writer of the book, that is fine, okay, but he have sold his own type of rights to the publisher. Okay, that means the publisher is the highest authority regarding that book. So this type of the adaptations are also there, some arrangement of works are also there, which are protected under the convention. Then right to perform in public dramatic, dramatico-musical and musical works. Okay, so any new music or new dramas are there, they are able to perform in the public. Right to communicate to the public in performance of such works. Okay, during the performances, they may be able to communicate with the people. Right to make a reproduction in any manner or any form. And nowadays, we are having one most important example of this reproduction of any work. Okay, that is number of old songs are there which are got remixed by any other musicians. Okay, and then that song is getting popular, and again there is a benefits. Okay, and here whenever you are using old or original song, you have to take the permission from the original author, original or the persons which are related to the work. Okay, So here it is one of the important right given to the producer, given to that author of the song. Then right to use work as a basis for an audiovisual work, and right to reproduce, distribute, perform in public or communicate to the public that audiovisual work. Okay, now here distribution and production of that particular series of the song, movies are one of the important aspects. Nowadays, again, if we discuss about the movies, a number of movies are got leaked when they got released on the same day it come on the website, some websites. In these cases, the producers, directors of the movie will get suffer with respect to their economical benefits. So you need here, they will have the right to go to the court against that website, against the persons which are involved in such type of the things. This is also one of the important right under the Bernese Convention. Moving on to the next slide, moral rights. Now, in the moral rights, again, some important things are there in which mutilation is there. Okay, mutilation means what? Mutilation is nothing but the, if any story is there, for example, or any book is there, other person, other author is copying that, doing some or he just deleting some part of the story, getting some part from the book, or exchanging that particular with some other information. Okay, so this type of the activities can be called as a mutilation. All these are prohibited under this convention. Then defamation. No, defamation is also called as a modification. Okay, modification and defamation, almost both these words are the same, and both are showing some modifications. Okay, so if any other person, other entity which is doing certain things, certain changes, and again reproducing it. Okay, it's nothing but your deformation or modification. Then other derogatory action in relation to the work. Derogatory actions is nothing but doing some rumors or which may be harmful to the original work. All such activities are the examples of this derogatory actions. And here authors are also having the right to go against these derogatory actions related to their own work. Next, which would be prejudicial to author's honor or reputation, means all these derogatory actions which are harmful to the honor of our author or his reputation. In that cases, he will go against that particular person, entity who is behind this derogatory work. These are the some moral rights covered under the Bernese Convention. Then duration of protection. Okay, one of the important point with respect to our exams, objective type of questions are there related to this particular. So first of all, general rule, that is author's lifetime plus 50 years, means what? After the death of author, it may be protected for the 50 years. Okay, it's one of the important and the basic protection criteria under the Bernese Convention. Second, in case of anonymous or pseudonymous work. Okay, anonymous means what? Some stories are there, some literature is there which do not have any author. Okay, it is just a compiled story, we may say. Okay, so all type of this particular material comes under the anonymous or a pseudonymous work, which is also can be protected 50 years from the publication. Okay, yeah, somebody or whenever it got published, that can also be protected for the 50 years. Then in case of cinematographic work, 50 years from release or creation of work if not released. Now in case of this corona situation, okay, when any cinematograph or movie they got started to shoot, at that time they don't know whether after 1 year it will get complete or after 6 year it will 6 month it will get completed, and after 6 month what will be the situation. Okay, now in our currently we are suffering from this corona pandemic, and during this particular from last 5 to 6 months all the theaters are closed, and in this particular situation how these movies will get released. It may released online, but when producer is willing to release it in the theater, then he will have to wait. So in these cases they are not able to release the movie even it is completed, even it is registered. Okay, so that here 50 years from the release or creation of work means work is got created but not released because of some uncertainties, so that here it will get protected for the 50 years. Then in case of the works of applied art and photographic works, it is for 25 years from the creation of such work. So all these are the forms of protection or particular limits of the protection for the work under the Berne's Convention. So today we'll stop here. In the next lecture we'll continue with the intellectual property right treaties, and the last treaty is there, that is Budapest Treaty, which is related to the recognition of the deposit of microorganisms for the purpose of patent procedure. Okay, patent which we have discussed already. Till our next lecture you just revise the topic of patent so that it will be easy to understand the our next treaty. So thank you, we'll stop here, see you in our next lecture.